Hello, my name is Srdjan Verstovšek. I am a professor of medicine in the leukemia department at MD Anderson Cancer Center in Houston, Texas. Today, I want to speak to you about prefibrotic myelofibrosis. Identifying early stage myelofibrosis, who, what, how? In early 2016, WHO classification of hematologic neoplasms has changed when it comes to myeloproliferative neoplasms. WHO criteria for diagnosis of prefibrotic or early primary myelofibrosis have been brought to light, and now we have this as a new type of a disease among myeloproliferative neoplasms. Here are the diagnostic criteria for prefibrotic early myelofibrosis. There are several major criteria. All three major criteria are necessary for diagnosis of this disease entity. And number one is the most important one. This is a bone marrow biopsy where megakaryocytic proliferation and atypia should be documented without reticulin fibrosis more than grade 1, along with increased age-adjusted bone marrow cellularity, granulocytic proliferation, and often decreased erythropoiesis. These are the key findings in a bone marrow biopsy necessary for diagnosis of prefibrotic myelofibrosis. Of course, we need to exclude any other disease entity that may cause this problem, and we should be looking for presence of a JAK2, calreticulin, or MIPL mutations that are usually exclusive of each other and present in about 90% of patients with fibrosis. Minor criteria exist as well, and along with mandatory three major criteria, we should be looking for at least one minor criteria to make a diagnosis of prefibrotic myelofibrosis. The minor criteria include anemia, not attributed to comorbid condition, slight leukocytosis over 11,000, palpable splenomegaly, and LDH increase to above upper normal limit of institutional reference range. This is how we make a diagnosis of prefibrotic myelofibrosis. In more detail, we show on this slide what exactly we expect to find in bone marrow of patients with prefibrotic myelofibrosis. These are silent signs that one needs to look for because it is important to properly diagnose patients with this disease entity. Major question here is how to fully distinguish prefibrotic early stage myelofibrosis from patients that have ET or essential thrombocythemia. On this slide, I show bone marrow findings in essential thrombocythemia patients. There are differences in the number of cells in the bone marrow and in the size and shapes of megakaryocytes. These are the key differences between the two disease entities, prefibrotic myelofibrosis and essential thrombocythemia. Now, why does it matter? It does matter because the clinical course of patients with ET differs when we talk about clinical course of patients with early or prefibrotic myelofibrosis. As shown on this slide, the difference exists in incidence of transformation to overt myelofibrosis, of a transformation to acute myeloid leukemia, as well as in overall survival. These differences are pronounced when we talk about prognostication beyond the 10 years. The overall outcome is good for both disease entities, but the differences exist when we look at 10 or 15 years from the diagnosis. The key difference here is the bone marrow biopsy and analysis of the bone marrow biopsy slides. So the key area of concern, therefore, at this moment in time is reproducibility and a low degree of concordance that may exist among hematopathologists. We can therefore summarize the progression of the disease from ET to prefibrotic myelofibrosis to overt myelofibrosis by looking at the progression in the bone marrow fibrosis as a single most important item. As it's shown on this slide, with a progressive fibrotic transformation from MF0 to MF1 and then 2 and then 3, these are the 4 degrees of a fibrotic process in the bone marrow, we clearly see the clinical relevance of such a progression by affecting the production of the bone marrow cells, by decreasing the blood count, by increasing the progression in a spleen size, by worsening the quality of life, and finally the most importantly affecting the overall survival of the patients, as is outlined in the bottom of the slide. In summary, prefibrotic myelofibrosis is a new entity in WHO classifications of myeloproliferative neoplasms. Its identification relies heavily on specific bone marrow characteristics, and prefibrotic myelofibrosis therefore may be sometimes difficult to separate from ET. The bone marrow exam is a key. Clinical outcome of prefibrotic myelofibrosis is worse than ET, but better, much better than in patients with overt myelofibrosis. I would like to thank you very much for listening to this presentation. Have a nice day.